Hey there, my name is Melissa Wilson, and today I want to talk to you about what to do when life hands you your ass. What do I mean by that? It is no secret that people in active addiction throw a nuclear weapon on their lives and just obliterate it. The lives of active addicts frequently have chaos and pandemonium going on, and it not only affects their lives, but those closest to it, their loved ones. And when we get sober, now we're left facing the destruction and we have massive damage control to take care of. Broken relationships are common, whether that means breaking up with someone or divorce, children getting taken away by authorities, or maybe they get sick of the addiction and move out. Maybe you've lost jobs, one or more. Maybe there's financial issues, bankruptcies. Maybe there's legal issues. Now you got felonies on your record or DWIs or what have you. All this is very common. And now we're no longer running from it and making it worse. Now we got to face it. How do you handle that? How do you handle that up here? This is what I'm going through right now. And so I'm going to tell you how I'm getting through it. So come along with me. Okay. First things first, you have to feel the feels. You got to feel it to heal it. You got to go through it to get to the other side. Us as addicts, we want to look outside to fix what's inside, and that's not going to work here. Okay, we can't fix the chaos of our lives by looking outside to fix the inside. It doesn't work. Not anymore. There's a lot to unpack there with those emotions. For me, there's a lot of denial, a lot of pride that I have to chip away at. Got to really chew on some humble pie that I don't like, and I'm sure you don't like it either. There's sadness, disappointment, regret, maybe all the stuff that you got to work through to get through. So journal it out, talk it out with somebody else, cry if you have to, whatever it takes. Don't live there in those emotions. Feel them, acknowledge them, and do your best to work through them. Wallowing in self-pity can be done for a moment. Just don't live there. Another thing to do is to be ready to accept what you need to do, not what you want to do to repair some of these situations. When we're in damage control and trying to repair years, most likely, of addiction-riddled lives, there's a lot of things that we're gonna have to end up doing because it needs to be done, not because we wanna do it, because it needs to be done. It's gonna be uncomfortable. It's not going to be what you want to do, and you're not going to be happy about it, quite frankly. Again, go back to what I said before, feel the feelings and do it anyway. And perhaps one of the most important things is share with other people your support system. Share with them what you're going through, all of it, your emotions, the actual circumstances, plus the way you're feeling, so you can get an unbiased opinion on how to move forward. I know when I'm wrapped up in my emotion, I don't think clearly. I react and think through emotion and not by logic. And so sharing what I'm going through with my support people and getting their feedback helps me work through the situation. And again, be prepared for them to tell you what you need to hear, not what you want to hear. These are times where the honest truth most likely is gonna suck and it's gonna hurt. But these are also the times where we gotta do what is necessary and needed to get through the damage control period of recovery. And that's exactly what I did last night. I went to my women's meeting and I bared my soul as best I could and I got feedback. And a lot of the feedback I didn't like. I knew I was gonna hear it, which made me hesitant to even share it, but I did anyway because I knew that was the right thing to do. I told them how I was feeling because basically what that is saying, this is how I feel. I need someone to talk me down from these feelings so I can move on with life in a logical manner instead of an emotional manner. The damage control portion of recovery is really difficult. Very, very emotional. So to recap just real quick, feel the feelings to work through them. You got to feel it to heal it. Be ready to accept and do what you need to do, not what you want to do. There's not always the perfect happy ending. You just have to do what's necessary. and then share what you're going through, the situations and the emotions, with other people so they can help you through it, so they can help you look at it from an unemotional opinion, so you can see more clearly and work through the situation as best as possible. I want to know what you found most helpful in this video. So drop me a comment, let me know your biggest takeaway. Also, if you're liking the content, give me a like and subscribe. I will be coming at you weekly with videos on recovery, mindset, self-talk, mental health, all the things. If you want to take your recovery further and want to get with a group of people who are working on mindset, self-talk, mental health in recovery, you want to join my Facebook group, Serenity Seekers. The link is in the description. It's a growing community. It is full of empowering, impactful things that you can use right now to improve your life, your mental health, your recovery, all good things. Look in the description for the link to my Facebook group. Don't forget to leave a comment. Tell me your biggest takeaway. Like, subscribe. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.